son on it and said, you have just won a vacation for two to Orlando, Florida, where the sun is shining, where it's 80 degrees. Now, make sure you're in this 30 degrees now, 30 below now. And here they come with this card that says that you have won a vacation in Florida for two, all expenses paid. Would you believe that?
I would say, what's the catch?
Well, see, somebody would say, what's the catch?
Yeah.
But they've written it out for you and got it all formed up, got a picture of the sunshine, got a nice picture of the beach, hallelujah. Got people sitting on the beach, hallelujah. You see the picture they portray for you in the midst of winter. They show you about summertime and about how good it can be, hallelujah. But let me tell you about a God, hallelujah. Right. That in your dark hour, hallelujah, you can call him up, 1-800-JESUS, and he'll be right there on the line, hallelujah. He won't have to paint a picture for you because he's already wrote it in the book.
All right.
That's right. How good.
66 books of the Bible, hallelujah. He's already put it in. But how many of us take the time to read it? Just as we read that card, with all the enthusiasm, like we're getting ready to go to Florida. How many of us would read the book just like we read that card, thinking that God, hallelujah, is going to take me to the sunshine. God is going to make a way out of no way. Because we say a lot of things, but do we really believe them? Come on, our favorite line is, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. How many of you say that?
Yes.
But how many believe that?
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Amen. Yes. See, it's easy to say it, hallelujah. It's easy to say those things, hallelujah, that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, hallelujah. It's easy to say those things, but we can't even sometimes get the smaller things like our prayer, hallelujah. How many still know the prayer? How many of you still get on your knees at night and say your prayers?
Yes. Our Father.
Come on now. Our Father.
Yes.
Some of us about that far forward as we know is our Father. But if you always remember that God has already wrote it down, because he knew some of us would have a hard time remembering what he said.
Amen.
No weapon formed against us shall prosper. All things work together for the good of them that are called according to his purpose. How many believe that? No weapon formed against you shall prosper. We got to get it deep down in our souls that we're on the way, hallelujah, that whatever's standing in your way could be just the picture that's in the mirror. It could be just self standing in the way of your own progress.
That's right. That's right.
Okay, that was my introduction. Let's go to the Word of God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's go to the Word of God. I believe. Come on, my reader, read for me. We're going to John chapter 20, verse 24 through 31. A lot of you are really familiar with this. Hallelujah.
Amen. John 20, beginning at verse 24.
Uh-huh.
But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples wherefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my fingers into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe.
Okay. See, here we go again. You know the story about Thomas. He wasn't even with the disciples when they first saw Jesus, like some of us. We were doing other things. We were busy doing other things when Jesus showed up on the scene. Hallelujah. Yeah. And we still don't believe it. Some of us still want to thrust our hands into his side. Some of us still want to see the nail print. We want proof that we've seen Jesus. Hallelujah. How many of you still want to see the proof?
Amen.
You want to see the proof?
Amen.
That he actually did. That he actually was nailed to a cross. That you want to see the nail in his feet. Hallelujah. You want all that proof before you believe that there is a God.
Yes.
But yet some of the things that goes on today, we're believing those things already.
Yep.
What if I told you that the person that found St. Philip was an African American?
Yeah.
Now they want to call her a saint. Would you believe me?
Yeah.
Well, I can go get it and write it down for you and put it in the paper. It's already in there.
Yeah.
was on the internet. Come on, come on, come on, people of God. Because some of y'all still, if it's on the internet, you believe it.
Right.
Yeah, really.
But when God can actually write it for you, some of you still won't believe because you want to see God. Mm. But the only God you may see may be in me, or you, or the one that's sitting next to you.
That's right.
Amen. But can you hear God?
Mm.
My thing is, can you hear God? Do you believe what you hear? Will you believe God if you heard God? Come on, you know my demonstration. You just close your eyes and I told you directions. You can still follow those directions with your eyes closed. Because you hear my voice. And this is what God is trying to get you to the point where you believe, where you hear my voice and you'll begin to move. Or do I have to stand here and say, well, this is God. Come over here and thrust your hand in my side so you can be able to understand that this is really me. Come on, look at the nail. Open your eyes for a minute. See the nail in my hand so I can show you that this is actually me. Because see, some of us really don't know who God is. We're like Thomas. We sit in the back. We like the rest. We didn't go when everybody else went. We want to go when we get ready. And then when we do sin, we like, that ain't God. That ain't really God. That's just that actor. What his name is? He just played God. He played God on TV. That's not really God. Because if God was really to show up in your life, what would you do? What would you do if God actually showed up? What if you saw the man standing there with the nail pressed in his hand? What if you saw him and had the cut in his side, had it thrown on his head? What would you do?